Addressing the media today, police spokesperson Fred Enanga revealed that the Shujaa operations in DR Congo are continuing to register tangible results. Over the weekend, the Joint Securitas Force made a breakthrough after killing Medin Kalubo, a famous ADF commander that has orchestrated a number of rebel attacks in the region. According to security, Kalubo was one of the masterminds of the November 2021 bombings and even the recent attempted bomb attacks in the city.
The now deceased Medin Kalubo was one of the perpetrators of the deadly bomb attacks in Komamboga, the suicide bomb on a bus along at Mpiji, the suicide bomb attacks at CPS and Parliament Avenue. He was very important in ADF because of his ability to plan and coordinate terrorist operations. So his death has actually dealt a very significant blow to the ADF and will degrade the group's ability to operate in the DRC and also in Uganda.
Meanwhile, Ugandans have been urged to be extra careful during the rainy season due to constant flooding of several city suburbs, where cases of drowning have also increased. Those living in flooding-prone areas have been cautioned on safety, while pedestrians and motorists have been warned against unnecessary movements during the heavy rains.
People who are living in low-lying areas or next to rivers and streams have to exhibit a lot of caution, if not evacuate to safer places or higher grounds when the water level arises. And they should always take special care during storms, as sudden floods can easily affect them. Then there is a danger of flowing water over roads and low water bridges. Flowing water applies pressure to contact areas. The higher the speed of the water, the higher the pressure. So we advise motorists to be careful and not drive through flowing water, because you don't know the state of the road or the bridge.
From Kampala Metropolitan, police are hunting for a young man who allegedly murdered his university girlfriend. Rashida Nakadu, a 23-year-old, was found dead in her room.
On the night of September 23rd, the deceased had a friend over whom the neighbors believed was a lover, given that the same person would visit her over the weekend. It is unfortunate that the police was informed of a suspected murder after they found the colleague's phone had door locked. We responded at the scene and found her dead. She had several stab wounds and possible signs of strangulation. We forwarded or conveyed her body to City Mortuary Mulago, where we are trying to ascertain the exact cause of death.
Meanwhile, police in Wakiso District are investigating circumstances under which three people were murdered in an attack that happened at Skyline Jet Car Washing Bay at Kavule Ward in Gombe Division.
The victims in this senseless act have been identified as Mr. Mayende Geoffrey, 35 years of age, a prominent businessman and owner of the establishment, as well as two security guards, that is Tumusime Bright and Harrison Fred. The police responded at the scene after Mr. Mayende Geoffrey reported the attack on his guards.
Report compiled by Charity Marion and Rachel Nachwala for the news.